Hello guys, this is Deepak Mishra once again, and before taking up the last few questions that were asked in 2017, I would like to inform you guys about a video which I recently came across made by Tejas Ghetia and Nishant Chirotia. Here, this video, Nishank has recently, these two guys, very ambitious and very hardworking people, they have gotten into residency some time back. Nishant has gotten into radiology now, and Tejas is doing psychiatry. And in this video which I've seen, Nishant has shared very beautifully his pathway of getting into radiology, his obstacles which he has faced, the work which he has to do to get into radiology. Because the question is always, people ask a lot of time about radiology, because you guys know radiology is a high-end branch, and for a foreigner, a foreign graduate getting into radiology in Germany is an example. I congratulate Nishank Chirotia and Tejas Ghetia for making that video, and I recommend my viewers and subscribers to that, watch that, so that to gain some perspective about the process, and it proves that if you are persistent and if you are willing to give time and hard work simultaneously, then it is possible. It is not impossible to get into radiology. So that's a very nice video. Guys, watch it. I'll share the link in the description of this video. You guys can watch it later. So coming to the questions which were asked. Sana Lari writes, what about part-time job for students and names of medical universities too? Sana, part-time job for two students, what part-time job students do is work in McDonald's or Burger King or petrol pumps, filling the tanks, or those are the part-time jobs which normally students do. But as a doctor, as a medical student, as a doctor, it depends upon your visa. If you come on a student visa, then you can work part-time. But if you work, come on a Sprach visa or some other visa, or a job seeker visa, then you're not allowed to do that work, which is non-doctor work, which is non-medical work that you're not allowed to do. And names of the medical universities, that you can find on Google, Sana, come on. You Google medical universities in Germany, you'll find an entire list of that. So I don't have to mention the entire list over here. Then Soliha Rizwan asks about the preparation books for dentistry. There are some books, Soliha, as I told you, the process for dentistry, I have not come up with a complete package as of yet, and entire plan as of yet. I am working on it, and soon, as I'm telling, that in 2018, I have plans, and there are, it's inclusive, it's going to be a corridor for healthcare professionals, those who want to work and learn in Germany and work and immigrate and integrate here in this society, in this culture. There's a lot of work to be done in this field to build a healthcare professional corridor for healthcare professionals, and dentistry is going to be one pillar of it. And I will come with the entire process very soon, Soliha. Just wait and keep watching these videos. Remo Teje, he writes, his name is Pradeep or Praeep from Tamil Nadu, completed MBBS from Deemed University. And some doctors say that Deemed University degree is not valid for doing PG in Germany. Pradeep, I would say if you have a medical license, if your university is in India, obviously it has to be MCI recognized. If it is recognized from Tamil Nadu Medical Council and MCI, then with your license, with your state medical registration from Tamil Nadu, you are valid. It's valid to work in Germany. It's not the information which you have got from other doctors is wrong. It is all about license. If you are from deemed university, you are government university, private university, it's irrelevant. If you are allowed to work as a doctor in that state, it's fine. You are an eligible candidate. Rahul Amin asked the same question. MBBS course in Germany. Eligibility for MBBS course. See, eligibility is very general. You have to complete 12 years of course. Actually, for Germany, it requires 13 years. So 12 years you will be doing in your country, and 1 year you will have to do Studienkolleg here. So that will complete 3 years, and then you have to take multiple exams and clear those exams, and at the end your selection in medical college or not selection will depend upon your scores on that exam. Sonia Sunny writes, your videos are helpful, a very big smiley, thank you very much. I heard that they teach in German medical university too. Yes, you heard it right, Sonia. Everything here in Germany is in German language. The medical curriculum is in German. The postgraduate training is in German. The books are in German. Patients are German. They speak German. And the diagnosis are in German. And treatment is in German. And the name of the drugs are also in German. So, yeah, how about books? Everything is German, as I answered already. Supreeta Naman writes, hello, Mishra sir. हमारे इंडिया में जैसे नीट होता है वैसे जर्मनी में कोई एग्जाम होती है गवर्नमेंट कॉलेजेस के लिए. सुप्रीता, जैसे आप हमारे इंडिया में नीट होता है वैसे जर्मनी में भी एग्जाम्स होते हैं, और वो एग्जाम एक नहीं होता है, बहुत सारे एग्जाम्स होते हैं, मल्टीपल एग्जाम्स होते हैं. जैसे कि आपको लैंग्वेजेस पूरे करने पड़ते हैं, लैंग्वेज का लेवल B2 तक आपको पूरा करना पड़ता है. फिर आपको एक साल का स्टूडेंट को लेकर करना पड़ता है, बिकॉज आपकी जो 12th तक की जो स्टडी होती है इंडिया में, वो यहाँ पे 13th तक की स्टडी चाहिए. यहाँ पे 13 ईयर्स का स्टूडेंट स्टडी होता है, स्कूल स्टडी. तो इसका आपको एक साल का स्टूडेंट कॉलेज करना पड़ता है जर्मनी में आके. इसमें आपको लैंग्वेज भी सिखाएंगे, इसमें आपको साइंस के सब्जेक्ट सिखाएंगे, फिजिक्स केमिस्ट्री मैथ्स सिखाएंगे, बायोलॉजी सिखाएंगे आपको उसमें. सो ये सब करने के बाद आप एग्जाम दोगे, और एग्जाम में आपका जो स्कोर आएगा, जो परसेंटेज आएगा, उस हिसाब से आपका डिसीजन होगा कि आपको एडमिशन मिलेगा या नहीं मिलेगा. सो एक एग्जाम नहीं होता, मल्टीपल एग्जाम्स होते हैं जर्मनी में. सो इससे उम्मीद है कि मैंने आपके क्वेश्चन को आंसर किया है, एंड आई होप, उम्मीद करता हूँ कि आपको आगे आपके करियर में आगे बढ़ने में सुविधा होगी. सो नेक्स्ट, राजेश प्रभाकरन राइट्स, डॉक्टर दीपक थैंक यू, यू आर वेलकम. I found your videos very informative, very nice about, okay, last part is the question that you want to communicate with me, Dr. Rajesh Prabhakaran. I have a website and I will share the link on the description section of the website. There is a WhatsApp number, there is a Skype ID, there are programs which you can choose. So you can contact me and my company through that. Furkan Kaya writes, can you please make a video about EU graduates? Yes. Yeah, next question is again from him. What are the eases for EU graduate doctors? Okay, Furkan, I understand that it is not very easy for you to find information about EU graduates, because maybe the reason is that it is not so difficult for EU graduates and EU citizens. I'm talking about EU graduates who are also EU citizens. For them, it's not very difficult. That is why apparently there is no video made for that, or there are less information. For EU graduates, if you are EU citizen, there are two cases. EU graduate, you are a EU citizen. In that case, you have to have that language proficiency, that is B2 level. Then you can apply for approbation directly by the medical council. In Germany, it's Erstekammer. Then they will test your Fachsprachprüfung, because your degree from EU is equivalent here, but your language also has to be equivalent to that level to work in German setup. So you will not have to take that Gleichwertigkeitsprüfung, that is Kenntnisprüfung, but your language will be tested by approbation. There's a Fachsprachprüfung. So you have to take that. Other case, if you are you are a EU graduate, but you're a non-EU citizen. In that case, your process is same as I have discussed so far, that you have to complete language, appear for Fachsprachprüfung, then they will do a Gutachten for your documents, that they will analyze if your documents are equivalent to that of a German medical doctor, or your training is equivalent or not. If they find equivalent, then you won't have to take the exam. If they find it not equivalent, then they will offer you an exam, this Kenntnisprüfung. And if you clear that exam, you will get an approbation. So that process I have been explaining it. But if you're an EU citizen, things are very easy for you. You have to complete your language, complete Fachsprachprüfung, and get a approbation after your documents are verified, obviously, and legitimized. All right. So these were the questions, last questions for 2017, and I've tried to answer them. I hope this will help you. I thank you all guys for watching my videos, and I am overwhelmed by the appreciation and attention which I have received in last 1 year from you guys. And I hope to continue sharing this information through this. So far, I have been doing it very unprofessionally through videos and sharing general information. That I will continue. That is going to continue, but then I have other plans where I find that only this information which I give through YouTube videos is not sufficient for doctors, for candidates to progress in the path towards post-graduation or study in Germany or to move to Germany. So that is why I'm coming up with something more professional, because candidates have been asking me for more assistance, more help, credible help, most importantly, because yeah, that is very important apparently. So I'm coming up with another project. Details will be discussed in new video, and as I have already discussed about the vision, about the plan to build a healthcare corridor which will facilitate, which will help healthcare professionals to move, so, vice versa. If German professionals want to work and gain experience in India, or Indian professionals want to work and settle and immigrate to Germany. Also, it will not be restricted to the professionals, to the manpower. It will be it will have several other aspects as well, which will be discussed in new videos in the introduction to 2018. So, take care, you guys. I hope you guys had a wonderful 2017. Stay motivated, keep working hard, persistence and hard work will be paid, does not go unpaid. So have faith, take care, and happy new year. Bye bye.